Okay, time to do the upper radiator core support cross member. I'm going to bolt it into place, and then I'm going to measure up and make some brackets to hold the top of the radiator tank. Exactly where the radiator is going to sit, and so now I've got to make up some brackets off the top to clamp it down to hold the top of the radiator in place. Found myself a hole saw that I'll be drilling through the front next to the radiator bracket. I'll be drilling this to run the power steering cooler lines through. The lower radiator mount is installed. So the radiator is going to be like perfect, exactly where it sits. I just have to work on the top brackets. Yeah, I had to turn the fan, the radiator fan, upside down to make it fit on the radiator and clear the engine better. So when that happened, two of these brackets don't line up. So I'll be making new ones to hold the other two areas of the fan. just still mocking stuff up, and it's getting better and better. Clearances are tight, but it's going to work. Okay, I purchased foam padding, that way we can seal off between the radiator and the core support to stop any excess air coming through, and also to cushion the fan on the radiator and to make sure there's 100% seal coming through, so there's no air coming through, so all the air pulls directly through the fan for 100% cooling. Bend over right here, like so, and we'll put padding along this area of the bracket so it holds it in place. Looks like something like this will work great. Yeah, time to put first some foam padding down to block any unwanted air to make everything pass through the radiator. Perfect, that's going to work really good. Yes, finished items, custom made top radiator mount brackets. I think it's gonna work pretty good. Clearances still working out okay, so see how it goes when I put the hoses on. Okay, it's been a while since it's been out of the cover. Gonna bolt a couple of the couple of my wheels on the front, as these tires aren't holding air very well anymore, and we'll just go from there for today. Okay, time to hook up the drive shaft. Maybe we can find the hardware somewhere in the truck. And go straight down to the back of the transmission and hook it up. Okay, ready to install the drive shaft to the differential. There you go. Beautiful.